Professor Abdullahi, Professor Abdullahi Ambali is with us. kemudian dia insya Allah bisa menjadi lulusan dialis by the grace of God. I was saying that the whole of next week has been set aside for the 33rd convocation ceremonies of the University of Illinois. Just a few hours ago, this morning, we witnessed the Vice Chancellor's press briefing, along with a book presentation in honor of the outgoing Vice Chancellor, Professor Abdulgani Ambeli, chronicling his achievement during the last 5 years. The convocation proper comes up next Friday, inshallah, the 20th of October 2017. The day two of the convocation is next Saturday, the 21st of October 2017. The two events shall be preceded by the convocation prayer, of course, by this one, this is press briefing and the book presentation. But aside of that, there's going to be the convocation day slated for Tuesday, the 17th of October, and the convocation lecture on Thursday, the 10th, the 19th of October, 2017, inshallah. In view of these events, today's khutbah is devoted to the essence of convocation and the need to commit the whole event into the same hands of the Almighty Allah. We are going to summarize, because what I have here is on the 12th page, the 12th page presentation. But forgive me as I skip from one paragraph to the other. Because we are talking of convocation, I started by saying that a convocation signifies the ceremony held when students have finished their studies and are leaving a college or a university. I have the source. Beyond this dictionary meaning, a convocation ceremony is an occasion for acknowledgement of knowledge. It's an occasion for recognition of achievement. It is an occasion for appreciation of hard work. A convocation is an occasion for reward and distinction. A convocation ceremony is meant for commendation of excellence. A convocation ceremony is a celebration of wisdom and a resounding applause for breakthroughs. What the University of Illinois is doing next week, or has started this morning, is to acknowledge individuals who have excelled and distinguished themselves in different branches of knowledge, in agriculture, in the arts, in the business and social sciences, in engineering, in technology, in medicine, in pure and applied sciences, and of course, as you all know, in the mother of all fields, the field of education. There's nobody that is going to doubt that assertion. Here, the glorious Quran, attributing the honor in the act of teaching and learning, the act of education, the act of educating individuals, how Allah ascribes the honor to himself. Iqra. Bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Khalaqa al-insana min 'alaq. Iqra. Wa rabbuka al-akram. Alladhi amana 'allama bil qalam. 'Allama al-insana ma lam ya'lam. Sadaqallahu al-'azim. Sadaqallahu al-'azim. Created everything. Khalaq. There's no object. Khalaq. Khalaq hai. Khalaq hai. Khalaq hai. Read in the name of my Lord who created everything. Khalaq al-insan. so generous for the Almighty Allah that He taught man how to use the pen. He taught man what he never did. It is out of generosity for Rabbu Kana Akram. Your Lord, thy Lord, is the most generous. Worshippers and obedient servants of the Almighty Allah, many reasons can be advanced to justify the acknowledgement of knowledge during convocation and related ceremonies. In the first instance, to honor knowledgeable fellows is indeed an appreciation of the Almighty Allah, whose special grace is symbolized not only by knowledge, but also by the various tools through which knowledge is acquired. Listen to how this fact has been vividly illustrated by a particular verse of the glorious Quran in Surah 9. وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. It was the Almighty Allah who brought all of you in between Almighty from the wombs of your mothers. لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا. At that point in time, when the Almighty Allah was evacuating you from the wombs of your mothers, you didn't know anything. You were ignorant, ignorant of everything. But in order for you to come to know, to become knowledgeable, to become scholars, scholars that will be acknowledged and honored next week, in order to rise to that level, ja'ala lakum sam'a wala absara wala afida. Allah facilitated the process. Allah granted you, out of His generosity, granted you three basic faculties. Ja'ala lakum sam'a, granted you the ability not only to hear, but also to comprehend and understand whatever you hear. That was out of generosity, the highest peak of generosity. We didn't pay anything for that. In addition to that faculty, the ability to hear, not only to hear, but also to understand, and that also added the ability to see, not only to see, but also to be able to distinguish that this is Mr. Chairman of Council, this is the Vice Chancellor, this is a friend of the university. No other person can do that, give you that distinction ability other than the government.
These are not our making, they are the making of the Almighty Allah.
al-fadla, that is the way the Quran puts it. Inna al-fadla biyadin, biyadillah. Inna al-fadla biyadillah. Yuti man yasha, Allahu wasi'un. Verily, grace, any form of grace, whether it is that of, let's do that. Let's give the elaborate explanation. Verily, all forms of grace lie in the hands of the Almighty Allah. He grants the grace according to his divine desire. And that is the custodian of grace. Allah is great. The second segment of this khutbah is to commit the 33rd convocation ceremonies of the University of Glory into the same hands of the Almighty Allah. We should not take the event for granted. Just this morning, we were recalling the fact that 5 years ago, our Vice Chancellor was appointed, the outgoing Vice Chancellor was appointed. Look at this, fly. It just yesterday. So many things have happened within the last 5 years. I want to thank the Almighty Allah. We want to recall that we prayed at that occasion. And today, when we are saying the prayer, then let all the we realize the fact that the angels had said Amen, and that the Almighty Allah had accepted the grace. Today, the event that is commencing today is an eloquent testimony that the prayers offered 5 years ago were granted even before the prayer. I want to say Alhamdulillah, wa Amen. We should therefore not take the event for granted, that is the convocation event ceremonies, realizing the fact that the Almighty Allah can do and all. Realizing the fact that it is one thing to conceive an event, like we have conceived the 33rd convocation ceremonies of the university. It is another to plan for the event. It is a different thing to execute the plan. Four, it is yet another experience to weaken the execution. Five, for the plan and execution to succeed is another thing. And finally, it is a different, completely different matter for Almighty Allah to accept the activities and to reward the activities as act of ibadah. It is only through serious prayers and devotions that we can be taken successfully through the 6 stages identified above in connection with the convocation ceremony. At this material point in time, therefore, we want to commit the 33rd convocation ceremonies of the University of Islamic into the same hands of the Almighty Allah. And I want to create the indulgence of members of this distinguished congregation, those of us who are sincerely in support of this university and can afford to stay behind. The prayer we are offering now is going to very great, but we are going to have somewhat and not very elaborate, and somewhat elaborate after the Jumat service. Let us stay behind. As Imam Allah, those who know that so, in the name of the Almighty Allah, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, we pray thee, O Lord, one, to bless the original conception of this 33rd convocation ceremony of the University of Iran. Can we say Amen? Two, we pray Allah to bless the planning and all the preparations that have gone into the event. Can we say Amen? Thirdly, we pray Allah to bless the execution at the point at which this plan will be executed. May Allah bless the execution. Four, we pray Allah to grant all of us the special grace of witnessing the execution proper. Amen. we are moved and impressed at the press briefing when you were going through your achievements. And as you were chronicling each one, I was recalling the verse of the Quran that says, Wamaro Meta, Silver Meta, Wamaro Meta. For us to appreciate the Almighty Allah, we should attribute and ascribe all these achievements to Him, to the Almighty Allah. The Salah that has granted you the life, to the Allah, to the Almighty Allah that has granted you to not ask of Him. The ability to always put that attribution in the ground, in the bed of the ground, in the body of the Prophet, they all come from the Almighty Allah and to the Almighty Allah they will return. Thank Allah for life, thank Allah for various achievements, and pray Allah to grant you success in all your future endeavors. We also pray for the DBCs here present. We pray for our Muslim deans and directors. I didn't see the DC designate at the beginning of this program, but I can spot him at the top over there. Professor Suleiman Agen Abu Kareem is also here to observe today's human prayer. We pray the Almighty Allah that just as the Almighty Allah has granted the outgoing Vice Chancellor this huge success, the Almighty Allah will crown your tenure with something even bigger success. Amen. Better by far, may our prayer be granted. We also congratulate principals and officers of the university, staff and students, remember the area of the emirate, we remember the state and federal government, we remember members of this distinguished congregation, we remember all and Sunday. Ibadallah, inna Allah ya'muru bil 'adli wal ihsan wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha worshippers and obedient servants of the Almighty Allah. The Almighty Allah commands and interdicts in the above verse. The commandments are that by the adhibit, every one of us, we should be just. What is his son? We should be kind. What is in the ruler? We should be generous. To whom? To all and some. We know this creation. When it comes to kindness, when it comes to justice, when it comes to generosity, you will experience. Because Allah has not been discriminated against anyone of us. If he were to discriminate, none of us, but all of us, no one has a good name, the Almighty Allah, we have to deal with us according to our attitude. Nobody will stare. Not even the imam. So, just as Allah has been kind to you, be kind to others. Just as Allah has been just to you, be just to others. And just as He has been generous to you, be generous. The interdictions are that we should refrain from indecency, refrain from indiscipline, and refrain from acts of injustice. Please remember to wait for maximum of 15 minutes, maximum. After 20 minutes, you can leave. Let us wait, stay behind for a maximum of 15 minutes to pray specifically, somewhat elaborately, for the success of this congregation. Let us pray. When I'm